So, it's time for part four, the demo. How we're doing on the
There's some
questions?
questions. I don't know if you can see Chris's PC, but there's some questions about the H move and V move. I don't know if you're going to cover that with your demo.
Yeah, I have a screen which demos the H move and the V move. So perhaps we can do the demo and then see if that's answer enough. Anything else?
Now there's one question about the color handling, but I need to get an answer for that one, and I'll post the answers in the forums.
And there is a tool for step two and three, right? That you just showed.
Yes. There is not for all steps a tool, but I think steps one up until five have tools. But you will see that in the demo shortly anyway. So, I have to quickly switch over to a virtual machine and stop presenting my PowerPoint. So I suggest for you people to take a sip of your tea or your coffee, and I will be back shortly. Yeah, and my virtual Windows 10 machine is coming up. Perhaps some of you have spotted the Universe Anywhere icons over here for my former presentation. What I'm going to do, I'm going to make the screen a bit larger. I'm going to my project directory. Starting up Uniphase 9.7. And no, my resolution is gone again. Okay, no problem. We'll have a very big resolution this afternoon, and it will be very visible for the audience. So here is the here are the different themes. So if I go to mobile, I have shortcuts related to the mobile theme. If I go to web, shortcuts related to the web, and desktop, shortcuts related to the desktop. You can let me get this one out of the way. In your preferences, the presentation preferences, this should all look familiar to you if you are a Uniphase developer, except for the left top part. There's the radio button, start page, mobile, web, desktop, or integration. Here you can set your favorite starting point. If you work, if you develop a lot for mobile or web, you can choose that one. And if you develop a lot for the desktop, you can choose that one. So I've chosen the desktop, as you can see. So I always start with the yellow part. So here are the some shortcuts I have added. So this is the part that is customizable. I can click on every column, sort them, even on creation time. There is a search as you type function on top, like this. Here are all the tools. And if I sort them on the description, I've changed the description with the steps. So there are tools for step one, step two, step three, four, five, and then step six and step nine. I have to add to this that these tools, of course, were custom made for this lab project of modernizing the Uniphase UDE, which means that not necessarily all these tools are necessary for your application. Or the other way around, perhaps you would come across to a unique situation in your application that is not covered in the lab modernization project. In this latter case, you would have to create your own tool to solve your problem. But of course, you could take a peek at how these tools are programmed and get some inspiration from that. So back to all the shortcuts. First, I'm going to show you this form. This short form has almost all the new properties in it. And if I run it, we can sort of play with it. For instance, attaching it to the left, here it goes, attaching it to the right, here it goes, to the top, to the bottom. If you do an H move, if you do a V move, we can play a bit with the colors, like this. This is the back color. Here's your border color in black. A drop shadow color in dark green. So now you have the drop shadow. Foreground color is now hardly readable, so I will use some dark blue, royal blue, number 4. Back color starts. The gradient starts. We would have need a back color for that. First, define a gradient. Like this. So here we have a gradient starting at the right, going to the left. There is a field for the border radius. So if I'm increasing the size of the border radius, my corners get more round and round. Here's the thing with the back image, and the four balls are back, and they are moving with the screen altogether. So this is pretty much all the possibilities with the new properties. And my guess is that this would also cover the question about the H move and the V move.
Let's see if it comes back.
Yeah. So we will make sure that this form is also available on uniface.info to download, and you can then import it in your repository and also play with it. And again, I can advise to read Jasper's blog on styling entities and area frames in Uniface 9.7, because the blog contains more details than my presentation. So closing this screen, and now using the search function, I really going to like this. And sorting on the steps of the, I'm now switching over to the third part, the 10 steps modernization plan. So taking a look at the first tool, it looks like this. If I run it, it looks like this. I have to say, in my repository, I have imported a very classic demo application back from Uniface 9.7. With great thanks to Dave Yexley, who still had this in his personal museum. We migrated, Bert Hogendoorn, my colleague from services, professionally migrated this application to 9.7. So it's now in my 9.7 repository. Thanks, Bert. And we're going to use these tools on this Formula One application. So I'm going to do a retrieve. And yeah, apparently now it's found. Like I said before, it's no guarantee that all these tools are necessary for your project, for your application. So we can sort of skip step one for the Formula One application. Going over to step two, running the form, doing a retrieve, and here is something. These are all very familiar names: W driver, W entrant, iCar, I driver. These are index forms. It all has to do with Formula One, of course. The buttons from left to right. It starts with the retrieve. Then there is a conversion function from RGB to hexa. I'm clicking it now and converting it back. Migrating the index color to property color when empty, goes like this. Migrate the index color to property color always, as I explained in that part of the presentation. And removing the property color when it's the same as the window color. As long as you don't hit the store button on the right, nothing has been changed in your repository. And you can still do a clear, do another retrieve, and play some more. So this is step two. This is the do. Okay, taking a sip of my tea because we have some lag. And we're back to the start form, where I now open the step three tooling. And I run it, I do a retrieve. And step three also has no hits in my project, so I can just forget about this. There's no need to use this tool. That was the entity column modification tooling. Over to the step four tooling for the grid. When I test it and retrieve it, we do have some hits. However, these hits are the components of the tooling themselves. So there's no need to change anything in this because we would then change the tooling forms themselves. I will still demo some of this. The properties border type flat and border color silver. You may remember that this was done to have a better outline of the area of a grid widget. And with a button, we can now easily add them to the full property string, as you can see. And again, if I don't hit store, nothing has been changed yet in the property. And I'm going to the next tool. Step five tooling, the multi-occurrence. You may remember the occurrence that very hard to try it to be a grid widget before the grid widget was invented. When I run it, do a retrieve. Here it is. So we have quite a lot of these multi-occurrence things. For instance, in the driver entity, the race entity, so it's all in on model level. Entrant and car, all very familiar items in the Formula One application, of course. So you would like to add back color equals white, border type equals flat, and border color equals silver easily to these components. So it's basically a very simple tool, this one. There is a button to apply these properties, and bingo, they have been applied. And the next step would be to hit store to save these changes into your repository. Okay, closing this one, going to the next one. So step six, the form widgets. Taking a short break again to and we're good. So here's a retrieve, and the array dynamic is the demo form that I showed you with all the new properties on it. So this one would fall out of my scope of my Formula One application. The G underscore index is a Formula One form, so this would be in scope. A simple form to apply extra properties with a new value and a where value and a new widget type. And again, as long as you don't hit store, and nothing is changed yet, and you can still experiment some more. And also again, one should always use perhaps a sandbox environment for the first steps in such a project, and use proper staging and version control. So going, not every step had tooling. There was even one step that had such a quick and dirty tooling that Theo did not dare to show this tool. So this is the last of the tooling for step 9, the mod widgets form. When I run it, I hit a retrieve. These are all dictionary things, so they would of course not be in scope of my project. So nothing for me here to here it is. Formula One model has some entities and fields which fall in the scope. And again, it's a fairly simple form. You can add a property name, add a new value, add a where clause, apply it, and define a new widget type and apply it, and then store it. So this brings me to the end of the presentation, of the demo and of the presentation. How are we doing on questions?
Yeah, we're all right with questions, I think.
Okay. So this was the end of the demo. Of course, you can always follow us online, on YouTube, on LinkedIn, on Twitter, on Facebook, and on SlideShare, where we post these presentations. On our website, uniphase.com, and also on the uniphaseinfo.com, and especially the forum. We have a very lively forum. You're welcome to join and ask all kinds of questions. I would like to thank you all for joining this afternoon. If there are no more questions.
No, I don't think so.
No, okay.
Need to remove Daniel from the forums before he puts any more questions in there. So, everybody, we're going to wrap this up. So a couple of just key things I did send in chat. First of all, this presentation we're going to make available on SlideShare. That'll probably go up tomorrow. And then we're also going to create a series of recordings for the different sections of this presentation. I don't know exactly when we'll have those ready, but we'll make those available on YouTube. And we will also post into the uniphase.info forums that these are available. There's also the demo app, the little sample, which sort of shows how to use some of the functionality. We'll put that up onto the sample section of uniphase.info as well. We'll try and get that done in the next couple of days. So, and any questions, please dump them into the forums and we'll pick them up and work on them and hopefully answer them for you. There's also a few questions that we've captured from both this morning and this afternoon's sessions. We'll put the questions and the answers up in the forums over the next few days, okay? So uniphase.info, the forums, very important.
Okay. The Formula One app. Can we make the Formula One app available?
Who wrote it?
I think it's an internal. It used to be a demo app back in Uniphase 7.
Okay. So the question came about making the Formula One app available as a reference. I don't think there's an issue with doing that. It is just a very old app. I think I can remember using it when I was a qualified trainer way back when in the version 7 days. So we can make it available, but please just be aware that there's new stuff which has been made available in the product which will potentially supersede some of those techniques and so forth. But we're more than happy to take a look at sharing it. So again, watch this space and we'll see what we can do there, okay? So we'll wrap everything up and thanks everybody for attending. I think in total we've had about 140, 150 people across the two sessions, which is fantastic. And as somebody has just said, yep, we'll look forward to the next one as well. It's been fantastic. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much and goodbye.